Today in this video, we will discuss about what is meant by electromagnetic waves, which are the source of electromagnetic waves, and how many types of waves are there, what is their wavelength, frequency, and the uses of electromagnetic waves. Okay, all those things we will discuss. Okay, let's about today. We will discuss about the source of electromagnetic waves, then the electromagnetic spectrum and properties of electromagnetic waves and uses of electromagnetic waves. Okay. So first of all, we will discuss what is meant by source of electromagnetic waves. So already we have studied that a charge which is at rest can produce electric field, and a charge which is in motion can produce both electric field and magnetic field. No, magnetic field is produced only by moving charges, and electric field is can be produced either by moving charges or charges which is at rest. But to produce electromagnetic waves, the charges should be under acceleration. Only accelerated charges can produce electromagnetic waves. Okay. So for example, if an electron is revolving, that's why you might have studied in atomic structure. One of the drawback of Rutherford atom model was, but it was the drawback, because whenever electron is revolving around the orbit, it will emit electromagnetic radiation, because it is under centripetal acceleration, because of which it will emit electromagnetic waves continuously, and finally it should collapse into the nucleus. Okay, so that already you have studied there. No? So only we can say here that only accelerating charges can produce electromagnetic waves, and the frequency of the electromagnetic wave is equal to the frequency of oscillation of charge. So in the last chapter we discussed about LC oscillations. There also we mentioned that electromagnetic waves of frequency, particular frequency, that frequency is given by 1 by 2 pi into root LC, where L is the value of inductance and C is the value of capacitance. Now that frequency of wave is given by that. So the same thing is told here also. The frequency of electromagnetic wave is equal to the frequency of oscillation of charge. Okay. And now we will discuss about the electromagnetic spectrum. This is known as electromagnetic spectrum, which arranges these rays, all those rays, in decreasing order of frequency or in increasing order of wavelength. Okay. Either we can say that in decreasing order of frequency or increasing order of wavelength. So gamma rays have the highest value of frequency, then comes X-rays, then ultraviolet light, then visible light, then infrared rays, then microwaves, then short radio waves, television and FM, frequency modulated radio waves, amplitude modulated radio waves, and long radio waves. Okay. So if we are arranging them in the decreasing order of frequency, we can say that gamma rays has the highest value of frequency and radio waves has the least value of frequency. Okay. This is what table or what diagram is given in the text, same diagram only it is there. If it is not clear, you can refer your textbook diagram also, NCERT textbook diagram also. Okay. So here you can see that visible spectrum, that what we are seeing, how much smaller is in that electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, electromagnetic spectrum varies from 10, you can see that 10 to 10 raised to 28 hertz frequency. So in that, how much smaller part is there corresponds to visible spectrum that we are seeing. Okay, so it varies from 400 nanometer to 700 nanometer in wavelength. So violet has least wavelength 400 nanometer, and red has the highest value of wavelength, that is 700 nanometer. Okay, so this is known as electromagnetic spectrum. Electromagnetic spectrum means it is the arrangement of electromagnetic waves either in the decreasing order of frequency or in the increasing order of wavelength. That arrangement is known as electromagnetic spectrum. Okay. And now we will discuss the same thing only in one table we can see. Okay. So radio wave, what is the wavelength? It is greater than 0.1 meter. And frequency, how to find frequency? You can find once you know the wavelength, you can find frequency by using the formula F is equal frequency is how to find velocity is equal to F lambda. No, V is equal to F lambda. By using that, you can find frequency. Frequency is equal to speed by wavelength. By using that, you can find the frequency. Okay, and how it is produced, that is discussed here. Rapid acceleration and deceleration of electrons in aerials. In aerials, if there is rapid acceleration or deceleration of electrons taking place, that time radio waves are produced. And it is detected. How it is detected? By using receiver's aerial. Aerial antenna is there, no? Aerials, that only. Next comes microwaves. Its wavelength ranges from 0.1 meter to 1 millimeter. So frequency correspondingly you can find 3 into 10 raised to 8 hertz to 3 into 10 raised to 11 hertz. And it is produced in klystron valve or magnetron valve. Okay. And it is detected by point contact diodes. Next one is infrared waves. Its wavelength varies from 1 millimeter to 700 nanometer and its frequency ranges from 3 into 10 raised to 11 hertz to 4 into 10 raised to 14 hertz, and they are produced by the vibration of atoms and molecules. Okay. And they are detected by thermopile, bolometer or infrared photographic films. Next comes our favorite, that is light. Its wavelength varies from 700 nanometer to 400 nanometer and frequency ranges from 4 into 10 raised to 14 hertz to 8 into 10 raised to 14 hertz. They are produced by electrons in atoms emit light when they move from one energy level to a lower energy level. Already you have studied in hydrogen spectrum, Lyman series, Balmer series, Paschen series, Brackett series and Fund series. No. So in Lyman series lies in the ultraviolet region, Balmer series lies in the visible region, then Paschen, Brackett and Fund series lies in the infrared region, that already you have studied. So that same thing only here we are telling, electrons in atom emit light when they move from one energy. If they are coming from higher energy level to lower energy level, they will emit electromagnetic radiations. Detect how it can be detected by eye, our eye, human eye, not only human eye, where a majority of animals can detect light. Then photocells and by photographic films. Next comes ultraviolet rays. Ultraviolet rays wavelength ranges from 400 nanometer to 1 nanometer and its frequency ranges from 8 into 10 raised to 14 hertz to 8 into 10 raised to 16 hertz, and they are produced by inner shell electrons in atoms moving from one energy level to a lower energy level. Same way, they can be detected by photocells or photographic films. Next comes X-rays. Its wavelength ranges from 1 nanometer to 10 raised to minus 3 nanometer. Frequency ranges from 1 into 10 raised to 16 hertz to 3 into 10 raised to 21 hertz. And produced by X-ray tubes or inner shell electrons. And photographic films and Geiger tubes are used for the detection of X-rays. Next comes gamma rays. Their frequency is less than 10 raised to minus 3 nanometer. Wavelength is less than 10 raised to minus 3 nanometer and frequency varies from 5 into 10 raised to 18 hertz to 5 into 10 raised to 22 hertz. And produced in radioactive decay of the nucleus, no need to say, you know that, no? And it is detected by photographic films and ionization chamber. Okay, so the same that what we discussed in previous electromagnetic spectrum, same thing only it is shown here, but here only two more columns are added. One is that how it is produced and how it can be detected. Remaining that related to that wavelength and frequency, it can be observed from the previous diagram also. Okay. And now we will discuss about the properties of electromagnetic waves. Which are the properties? So the first property is that electromagnetic waves are transverse in nature. You know what is meant by transverse waves. What is meant by transverse waves? The direction of propagation and direction of vibration are perpendicular to each other. So in electromagnetic waves, what is vibrating? Electric field and magnetic field are oscillating. No? So we can say that electric field, oscillation of electric field vector will be perpendicular to oscillation of magnetic field vector, and the direction of propagation will be perpendicular to both. So if we are showing by diagram, we can show like this. So the purple color shows the electric field oscillation and yellow color shows the magnetic field oscillation, and the direction of propagation is shown here. Okay, so here we are in this diagram, we are showing that wave is propagating along x direction, electric field vector is along y direction, and magnetic field vector is along z direction. So here you can see one important thing is that whenever electric field vector is reaching maximum value, magnetic field vector also reaching maximum value, and whenever electric field vector is reaching minimum value, magnetic field vector also reaches minimum value. So that phenomenon, that property is known as, we will say that electric field and magnetic field are in same phase. That we will discuss later on. Okay. So this is clear, no? So purple color here we are showing by the electric field oscillation, and that yellow color we are showing for the magnetic field oscillation, and you can see that direction of or motion or propagation of the wave is perpendicular to both. Okay. So mathematical expression for this we can write like this. If we are showing, here we are in this expression, we are showing that wave is propagating along z direction and electric field vector is along x direction. So ext can be written as E0 sin kz minus omega t. The same expression last year in 11th you have studied in waves. So E0 sin, instead of k, k is wave number. So instead of k, we can write 2 pi by lambda. And instead of omega, we can write 2 pi f. So or 2 pi nu. That's why the second expression we are getting E0 sin 2 pi into z by lambda minus nu t. Okay. Or instead of that, we can write E0 sin 2 pi into z by lambda. Instead of frequency, we can write 1 by time period. That's why we are getting this third expression. E is equal to E0 sin 2 pi into z by lambda minus t by t. So, in the case of magnetic field vector will be perpendicular to electric field vector. So, if electric field vector is along x direction, no doubt magnetic field vector should be along y direction, because here in this expression it is clear that wave is propagating along z direction. How we come to know that it is propagating along z direction? Because from the term in that angle contains, no? Angle contains the term z. That's why we can say that wave is propagating along z direction. So magnetic field vector can be written as B0. What is B0 and E0 stands for? The amplitude of the wave. Amplitude of the electric field vector, B0 stands for the amplitude of the magnetic field vector. So we will get the expression for magnetic field as B is equal to B0 sin kz minus omega t. That's why I told you here the angle part will be same. There is no phase difference. Okay. Both electric field vector and magnetic field vector, when we are representing, amplitude will be different, but sine of that angle, it will remain same. Okay, so sin kz minus omega t, same we can represent either in terms of wavelength and frequency, or we can represent in terms of wavelength and time period. That's why we are getting the two expressions. B is equal to B0 sin 2 pi into z by lambda minus nu t, that is not vt, that is nu t. Okay, nu stands for the frequency. Or it can be written as B0 sin 2 pi into z by lambda minus t by t. Okay, is it clear? And now we will discuss the next property. Next property, what it is? Electromagnetic waves are produced by accelerated charges, that already we have discussed, and do not require a medium for their propagation. This is very much important. In the case of sound waves, They require a medium for propagation. That's why they are known as mechanical waves. But electromagnetic waves does not require a medium for propagation. Okay, that's why we are getting light from the sun. If they need a medium for propagation, it would have not come through vacuum. So we can say that it does not need a medium for propagation. And next one, the oscillations of, just I told you in the previous diagram when we discussed, the oscillations of electric field vector and magnetic field vector are in same phase. In same phase means whenever electric field vector reaches maximum value, magnetic field vector also reaching the maximum value. Same way, whenever electric field vector is reaching minimum value, magnetic field vector also reaching minimum value. There, the maximum value will not be equal. Okay, electric field vector's amplitude and magnetic field vector's amplitude will not be equal. But whenever electric field reaches maximum value, magnetic field also will be reaching maximum value. Okay, and next, all electromagnetic waves travel in free space with the same speed. So all electromagnetic waves are traveling with the same speed, that is given by C is equal to C. What is the value of C? It is given by 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second. How we are getting from this expression? 1 by root of mu 0 into epsilon 0. Mu 0 is the permeability of free space and epsilon 0 is permittivity of free space. Okay. So in any material medium, electromagnetic travel with the speed which is given, V is equal to 1 by root of mu epsilon, where mu can be written as mu 0 into mu r and epsilon can be written as epsilon 0 into epsilon r, or we can write it as C by n, where n is the refractive index of the medium. So we are getting from Snell's law also, no, n is can be written as C by V. No? That there also we discussed. Absolute refractive index is equal to speed of light in vacuum by speed of light in medium. And next, some more properties are there that we will see. The amplitude ratio of the electric and magnetic fields are given by E0 by B0 equal to C. We have written the expression E is equal to E0 sin kz minus omega t and B is equal to B0 sin kz minus omega t. So that ratio of the amplitude of electric field vector to the magnetic field vector will give the value of the velocity of light. Okay. And next one, the electromagnetic waves carry energy and this energy is equally shared by the electric and magnetic fields. It carry energy, no doubt at all, and that energy will be equally shared by electric field and magnetic field. In the case of electric field, energy is given by half epsilon 0 E square, and in magnetic field it can be written as B square by 2 mu 0. And electromagnetic waves transport linear momentum, and that momentum is equal to total energy by C, where C is the velocity of light. Then they are not deflected by electric and magnetic fields. Even though electric field and magnetic fields are oscillating and they are propagating, that waves are propagating like that, they cannot be deflected either by electric or magnetic fields. And they obey superposition principle. Already you know what is meant by superposition principle. That is, we can add waves. Okay. And they show properties of reflection, refraction, interference, diffraction and polarization. Already you have studied what is meant by reflection, refraction. And the other three topics we will discuss later on, what is meant by interference, diffraction and polarization. Next comes the electric field of an EM wave is responsible for its optical effect. Why? Because E0 by B0 equal to C. So E0 will be much greater than B0. That's why we can say that electric field of an EM wave is responsible for its optical effects. And now we will discuss about the uses of all waves. We will start one by one. First of all, we will start with the uses of radio waves. That already you know that they are used in radio and television communication system. No need to tell about that. And they are also used in radio astronomy. Okay, they are the uses of radio waves. And next we will discuss about the uses of microwaves. In radar system for aircraft navigation, we are using microwaves. And why they are using in a radar system, radar, you know that, no? Why we are using in radar? Because they are having short wavelength. And radar also provides the basis for the speed guns used to time fast balls, tennis serves and automobiles. To measure the speed, we can use radar, okay? Then in long distance communication system via geostationary satellites, we are using microwaves. Then in microwave oven, we are using microwaves. And how we are using, that is explained here. The frequency of the microwave will be matching with the resonant frequency of water. Okay. The frequency of the microwave will be matching with the resonant frequency. So what happens? Energy transferred will be maximum. So maximum energy, efficiently energy will be transferred to the kinetic energy of the molecule, because of which the temperature of the water increases and food will be cooked. Okay. And next we will discuss about the uses of infrared waves in the remote control of a TV or VCR. Now whenever we are changing the signal, these channels, and reducing the volume, everything, we are using remote, no? So there we are using infrared waves. Actually, the keypad will contain a small infrared transmitter. And it is used in greenhouses to keep the plants warm. Then it is used in haze photography. Haze photography means fog. During fog, that if fog is there, we cannot take photo clearly by using visible light. The scattering will be more. But infrared waves are less scattered than visible light by atmospheric particle. That's why it is used in haze photography. Then infrared detectors are used in Earth satellites. In Earth satellites, we are using infrared detectors. For what purpose? Both for military purpose and to observe growth of crops. Okay. Then infrared lamps in the treatment of muscular complaints. We can use infrared lamps. Then in reading the secret writings on the ancient walls. In the ancient walls, to know the to study about the reading of the secret writings, we are using infrared waves. Then in knowing about the molecular structure, we are using infrared waves. Okay. And next we will discuss about uses of visible light. Actually, no need to tell at all. We are getting information about the world because of visible light, and it can cause chemical reactions. Okay. And next we will discuss about uses of ultraviolet light. It is used in food preservation. Then due to its smaller wavelength, it is used in eye surgery. Okay, LASIK eye surgery, because of its shorter wavelength, it can be focused to very narrow beams for high precision application, such as LASIK eye surgery. Okay, why we are using in eye surgery? Because of its shorter wavelength. Okay, and next, in the study of invisible writings or forged documents and fingerprints, also we are using ultraviolet light. Then in the study of molecular structure also, we can use ultraviolet light. Okay. And these ultraviolet lamps are used in water purification. For water purification also, we can use ultraviolet light. Okay. And now it comes the uses of X-rays, that already you are familiar with X-ray, no? In medical diagnosis, because X-rays can pass through flesh but not through bones. In medical diagnosis, we can use X-rays. Why we are using X-rays? Because it can pass through flesh very easily, but cannot penetrate the bones. Next, in the study of crystal structure. To study about the crystal structure, we can use X-rays. Why we are using? Because it can be reflected and diffracted. What is meant by diffracted? We can discuss later on. Okay. So at least you know what is meant by reflection. So X-rays can be reflected and diffracted. And next, in engineering, for detecting faults, cracks or flaws and holes in the finished metal products. Once metal products are ready, if there is any faults or cracks or flaws or holes are there, that can be detected by using X-rays. Last year you have studied it by using sonar also, we can do the same. Okay. Then in detective departments, to detect explosives, diamond, gold, etc. in the possession of smugglers. So X-rays can be used for detecting explosives, diamond, gold, etc. Okay. Then in radiotherapy, to cure untraceable skin diseases and malignant growths. Malignant growth and skin diseases can be cured by radiotherapy by using X-rays. Next, we will discuss about the uses of gamma rays. In radiotherapy for the treatment of malignant tumors. Okay, tumors can be treated by using gamma rays. Okay. Similarly, in the manufacture of polyethylene from ethylene, there we are using gamma rays. Then to initiate some nuclear reactions, we are using gamma rays. Then to preserve foodstuff for a long time, because soft gamma rays can kill microorganisms. So to preserve food for longer time, we can use soft gamma rays. Okay, is it clear? So these are the various uses of gamma rays. Then to study the structure of atomic nuclei also, we can use gamma rays. Okay. So this is about electromagnetic waves. So already we discussed almost all points. So you can refer the textbook and you can study. So if you are having any doubt, you can contact me. Okay. Thank you.